Will your lake benefit from aeration? What types of lakes do we typically put aeration systems into? What I generally tell folks is there's very, very few lakes that I've ever met or come across where we didn't recommend putting aeration in. They benefit lake owners from north to south, east to west, deep water. About the only time we don't use them if we have one that's really too shallow that effectively gets stratified. Most lakes will benefit from aeration. But there's a common misconception when you say the word aeration. Most people think of putting bubbles and oxygen into the water, and that's really not the point of making those bubbles. A better name for these systems would be destratification systems. So aeration is all about preventing water from stratifying those warm and cold layers that set up over the summertime. Once those layers set up, the bottom water becomes dead, and we want to keep the water mixed all summer long to prevent those layers from ever setting up, keep the whole lake from stratifying. So the purpose of the bubble, we use high quality aeration systems that make lots and lots of small bubbles. The smaller the bubble, up to a point, the more effective and efficient it is to generate current that's actually lifting water from the bottom of the lake up to the surface and back down and just constantly mixing it, and that prevents water from stratifying. This lake's a good example of benefits of aeration. We first got into here, this lake it's an older lake. There's lots of nutrients bound up in the sediments on the bottom, and it would stratify. We're in East Texas. This lake was stratified by late April, and by the middle of summer, the nutrients that are bound up in the bottom have no oxygen, and they start to release phosphorus, and we'd get pretty bad blue-green algae blooms in this lake. Were pretty common in August and September after sitting there all summer with that dead water. So we put an aeration system in here 2 years ago, keep oxygenated water, and we're also doing stuff to work on the nutrients, bring those down. We've really cut down on algae blooms in this lake. Keeps the water cleaner and healthier and mixed up all summer long. Now, down south, the most important time to aerate a lake is in the summertime. As you move further north, their stratification is less of an issue, but we use aerators up there for a whole different purpose, and that's to keep fish alive over the winter, to reduce winter kill. Same thing, we'll take a lake and we'll shut down all but one or two aerator diffusers. We'll try to find the ones in shallow water. We want to keep one hole open, maybe two holes in a bigger lake, holes in the ice that we're just using the aerator to keep a hole in the ice that allows sunlight to penetrate into so that we can have photosynthesis and generate oxygen. Helps generate oxygen and also helps degas any gases coming up off the bottom over the winter time. So keep a hole in the ice in the winter, keep it destratified in the summer. Aerators are probably one of the most important tools we have. And once we get them, we might tweak them and maybe not run them 24/7 all the time, but they're pretty much running all year in most lakes we manage. So aeration, it's gonna benefit most lakes, probably benefit your lake. Definitely add it to your management program. It's going to help keep the water cleaner, maybe help reduce nutrients, help you control algae blooms in some cases, but overall just make your lake healthier, make your fishery healthier and more sustainable in the long term. Great to keep a healthy, sustainable lake.